السلام عليكم. Our lecture today is about persistent gestational trophoblastic disorder. Highly malignant chemosensitive tumor occur in two categories. Okay. Non-metastatic lesion, i.e. usually confined to the uterus in form of invasive mole and is followed 15% of primary hydatidiform mole. Metastatic lesion usually lead to the distant metastasize and is followed 5% of primary hydatidiform mole. Incidence and epidemiology. A geographical distribution similar to that of the hydatidiform mole in the West, 1 in 10,000 to 1 in 17,000 pregnancy. In the Middle East, intermediate position, Asia, 1 in 250 and 1 in 6,000. The age, as we know, more in the old, poverty, more in high poverty, with socioeconomic status, more in the poor. The antecedent pregnancy, they found that hydatidiform mole in 50% to 75%. Normal term pregnancy, 25%, and after abortion, 25%. In maternal blood group, they found it is more common in group A and less common in group O. The pathology of persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor. By microscopic appearance, what we are going to see? Dark hemorrhage tumor mass on the uterine wall, cervix, and vagina, and could perforate the uterine wall or invade a blood vessel, leading to the metastasis. In microscopic appearance, i.e. under microscope, what we see? In cases of choriocarcinoma, completely disorganized growth, يعني فتشي غير منظم, with bizarre form of cytotrophoblast and sensitiotrophoblast, with variable cellular anaplasia and absence villi. In the invasive mole, trophoblastic extensive deep myometrial penetration and may reach peritoneal covering of the uterus or vagina with necrosis of the muscles and preservation of villus matrix. Usually lacking tendency of widespread metastasis. How is the patient is presented to you, i.e. what is the clinical feature? Usually the patient presented with uterine cramp and bleeding, which is the most common complaint, and is either internal bleeding due to myometrial infiltration by tumor and lead to perforation and hemoperitoneum or external bleeding. Offensive vaginal discharge, cachexia, weakness, and pyrexia as disease advances. Not uncommon, patient has no specific complaint and she diagnosed during surveillance after molar pregnancy when one of the indications of chemotherapy is encountered. Sign and symptom of metastatic lesion. Metastasize may be local to the broad ligament and paracervical tissues or through bloodstream to the lung, اللي هي the most common site in 75% of cases. Follow symptom of head sneeze and hemoptysis. The vagina, next common site of metastasis, 50%, leading to bleeding nodule. CNS leading to the seizure and CVA and liver metastasize. What is the investigation? Usually we have to send for beta HCG, important in the diagnosis and the clinical staging of persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor. As we know, HCG should be normalized 48 hours after term delivery, 2 weeks after abortion, and 6 to 8 weeks after delivery, after HMOL, sorry. So persistence increased level of HCG mean persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor. What other investigation? Chest X-ray, very important to exclude or to detect lung metastasize. The imaging techniques, Ultrasound, CT scan, MRI. MRI is superior to ultrasound and CT scan in evaluating abdominal and pelvic organs and CNS metastasis. How you are going to stage persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor? They put a number of factors identify which influence prognosis of persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor in a positive way. They are as follows. Increasing HCG before starting treatment because it is reflect larger mass. يعني كل ما كانت الليفل مال HCG عالي معناته larger tumor mass. Metastasize and this include يعني يعتمد على site of metastasize. مثلا worst prognosis إذا كان عندنا CNS metastasize. Why? Because the chemotherapy agent usually does not cross the blood-brain barrier. أيضا ال worst prognosis بالليفر metastasize. Why? Because poor prognosis because chemotherapy rapidly detoxify in the liver. Number of metastatic lesion. The more the number, the poor the prognosis. يعني كل ما صار عندي أكثر من مكان يروح للتيومر معناته أنا bad prognosis عندي. Size of largest mass. The larger the mass, the poorer the prognosis. معناته increase بال التيومر سيل. الانتيسيدنت بريجنانسي الورست بروجنوسيس اذا كان الانتيسيدنت بريجنانسي استام نورمال بريجنانسي بيتر بروجنوسيس وذ ابورشن البيست بروجنوسيس وين انتيسيدنت بريجنانسي از اتش مول واي. لان اذا كانت المريضه هي جايبه طبيعي وطفل طبيعي واحد صعب يتوقع انه هاي ربما جستيشنال تروبلاستيك تيومر، فلهذا من توصل المريضة توصل لنا بمرحلة أخيرة من تشخص. لكن إذا هي المريضة يعني هذا الجستيشن تروفوبلاستيك ورا الـ HMOL يكون البروغنوسيس جود، لأن إحنا already put the patient under microscope. يعني إحنا المريضة اللي هي HMOL مخليها under surveillance لأن قلنا أكو فد 15% راح تحولون كوريوكارسينوما، فمن تجي المريضة من وقت تقدر تشخصها وتعطيها العلاج. بينما إذا كان normal breeding normal pregnancy ما راح تشخص من وقت لأن ما حد يتوقع احتمال هاي a case of gestational trophoblastic tumor. Pregnancy interval longer the interval between the pregnancy and chemotherapy the worse the prognosis. A previous unsuccessful chemotherapy associated with the prognosis. Why? أولا احتمال عندنا drug resistance may be due to the impervability of the chemotherapy to tumor mass because of scarring and fibrosis أو احتمال accumulating drugs toxicity. شافوا الـ ABO group worse prognosis in blood group B AB. الـ age poor prognosis إذا أكثر من 39 and إذا البارتي 3 and 4. Each of the above mentioned prognostic variable is giving a score ranging from 0 to 3. 0 إذا كانت absent and 3 if present. يعني مثلا إذا مريضة هي عندها عمرها 40 سنة وعندها metastasize in من للبرين. فهاي 30 وهاي 30 إذا صار المجموع 60. إذا هاي شنو نعطيها؟ نعطيها allocated as medium risk gestational trophoblastic tumor اللي هي between 55 إلى 95. So by calculating the score of the patient final score less than 50 allocated as low risk gestational trophoblastic tumor 55 to 95 allocated as medium risk gestational trophoblastic tumor more than 95 allocated as high risk gestational trophoblastic tumor so staging affects survival rate and choice of chemotherapy this based mainly on HCG levels and metastasis and is not pathological classification. Treatment. What is the treatment for persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor? The optimum result encountered in highly specialized center. Same policy of a treatment in invasive mole and metastatic cardiocarcinoma. Treatment modality ايش عندي؟ Chemotherapy اللي هي المينستي اوف تريتمنت، surgery certain limited indication، radiotherapy also limited indication and further management and follow up. نجي هسه نحكي على الكيموثيرابي اوف persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor in details. Chemotherapy is indicated in all cases of persistent gestational trophoblastic tumor. Metastatic or non-metastatic form of a tumor are highly chemosensitive. Protocol for chemotherapy agent are selected according to degree of the risk of patient, هل هم low, medium or high, which indicated by her pre-treatment prognostic score, الفاكتور اللي حكينا عنها. Low risk category response to single drugs and medium high risk category require combinations of drugs. هسه نجي على low risk categories. Survival rate 100%, يعني الحمد لله نسبة عالية. Carries best prognosis respond to single agent chemotherapy either methotrexate or actinomycin D. Methotrexate is the drugs of choice. Why? In single chemotherapeutic courses, because it is simplicity and low toxicity. It is low toxicity attributed to the availability of antidote, اللي هو منو folinic acid, which reduce toxicity and allow use of higher dose, يقلل التسممية مات الدواء ويسمح لنا نزيد الجرعة الدوائية. How to give methotrexate? Before starting chemotherapy, you have to send your patient for complete blood picture, liver function test, renal function test, and is given parenterally IV or IM, excreted in urine, so it is contraindicated in renal failure. The courses constitute 8 days. Methotrexate given every other days, alternating folinic acid, يعني يوم methotrexate ويوم folinic acid. HCG should be assessed twice weekly, يعني مرتين نشيكه بالأسبوع, to ensure that it is regression, يعني جاي ينزل satisfactorily. If HCG is increased or plateau, which mean drugs resistance, and you need to change the drugs. White BC count and platelet count sent for daily, so stop chemotherapy if white BC count less than 1,000, platelet count less than 15,000. Toxicity of methotrexate may be encountered. شنو السايد افكت مالته كل اللي احنا نعرفها؟ مايلوسبريشن اللي هي ثرومبوسيتوبينيا، جرانيولوسيتوبينيا، ميوكوس ممبرين، استوماتيتس، اوسوفيجيتس، فاجينايتس، كونجكتيفيتس، سكين راش، نيفروتوكسيسيتي، اند هيباتوتوكسيسيتي. When 8 days course completed, give 7 to 14 days rest, then start second course of methotrexate in the similar manner, and you need 2 to 4 courses. يعني ناخذ rest أسبوع إلى 14 يوم ونبدأ بالكورس الثاني. من similar manner احتمال نحتاج كورسين إلى 4 كورسات. To reach undetectable level of HCG, when HCG level undetected, يعني نطي 2 إلى 3 extra courses of methotrexate. Why? لأن شافوا approximately 100,000 trophoblast cell 100,000 may escape detected by radio immunoassay of HCG. The other drugs, اللي هو الاكتينوميسين دي, given voluntarily in courses consisting of 5 days, spaces by 7 to 4 days, rest, repeat courses until you reach undetectable level of HCG, يعني نفس الرجيم مالت الميثوتريكسيت, followed by 2 to 3 extra courses, monitor patient condition by complete blood picture, liver function test, renal function test, and is giving and monitoring patient response by beta HCG twice weekly. هسا نيجي نحكي على medium risk categories. هنا على ال overall survival rate 95%. They resist methotrexate when used as single agent. Combination chemotherapy improves prognosis significantly, and the following agents are added to methotrexate. يعني actinomycin, 6-mercaptopurine, fenacrostine, and cyclophosphamide. الهاي ريسك كاتيجوريز هنا انا البيجست ثيرابيوتيك تشالنج لان السرفايفل ريت راح تقل 40 إلى 65%. ريكواير 7 دراكس كومبينيشن كورسز انكلود الكليتنج ايجنت از كلونامبيوسيل ميثوتريكسيت اند اكتينوميسين دي اند فينيكريستين اند اذرز. They also require prophylactic intrathecal ميثوتريكسيت on each alternating courses to prevent CNS metastasize. Also these drugs combined in courses spaces by 7 to 14 days rest. Surgical treatment of the resistant gestational trophoblastic tumor. قبل لا يكتشفون الكيموثيرابي, in pre chemotherapy era, hysterectomy was the treatment of choice in the resistant gestational trophoblastic tumor. And at that time, it may result in favorable outcome with H mode or invasive mode, but was totally inadequate. يعني لا كان عندنا metastatic lesion choriocarcinoma. Now we are in the era of chemotherapy. Successes of chemotherapy replaced hysterectomy, favorable pregnancy outcome is possible after successful chemotherapy. So it's best to be avoided, avoid hysterectomy and preserve reproductive function. Surgical treatment, general indication indicated in the following situation. أولا, drugs resistance focus. Diagnose when find focus with the resistance increase in HCG despite drugs combination. So, hysterectomy if the focus confined to the uterus or salvage surgery, for example, lobectomy if the focus confined to the lung or vaginal nodule excision. Uterine perforation by invasive mole lead to the hemoperitoneum. Heavy uncontrollable uterine bleeding. Hysterectomy with the preservation of ovaries because ovarian metastasis is very rare. Radiotherapy, general rule. Hnana, not sensitive to the radiotherapy and is of no benefit in chemotherapy resistance tumor may be indicated in cases of brain or liver metastasis who develop hemorrhage into this metastatic lesion after chemotherapy. A further management of resistant gestational trophoblastic tumor. By quantitative assessment of HCG, the aim of follow-up is to diagnose remission, which define 4 consecutive weekly negative HCG assay, added to detect relapse, and majority of relapse occur in the first 12 months of remission, يعني أول سنة. The contraception essential during treatment and during the first year of remission by barrier methods, then oral combined contraceptives after normalization of HCG level. Follow-up scheme, monthly HCG assay in the first year, twice per year for 5 years, once per year for 5 years. A plus, follow-up previous metastatic lesion by appropriate test, chest X-ray for lung metastasis and MRI for pelvic and abdominal viscera, sorry, and CNS. And thank you very much for your listening.